He's just in love with Kamaya Din's husband since kindergarten. He's now a third grader. And he's the one I promised that I would bring the coconuts to. So he's actually teaching some of the students, you know, what they need to do and how they need to connect and how to turn their heads. I think I have a video next, a little bit of their work when they're practicing. I can't see. Here's one. So here's different students. This is Maddie, a kid. About 6 or 8 weeks, and other students were playing the Kamaya instruments, learning Sarakakau. I am not a master, so all of my students were playing the same melody. Some of them, hopefully, we will be able to either get a grant so that they can do an after-school program and have longer than 10 minutes, and they definitely would be able to do the songs that we were playing too. So these, I have a few students that I can show you in the beginning when they were learning. That was the Roniat. This is Lena working on the Kung Touch. And then she's kind of working on the ending there. And Michaela working on the Kung, actually it was the Kung Tung. The Kung Touch is the lighter one. Higher pitched. Oops, I thought I had one more. That's okay. All right. So here is our International Day performance. We actually pulled in some other students. This is Nana. He's recently come from Africa. My classroom seems to be the landing point for many immigrant children. I think they realize quickly that they don't need to speak English to come and make music. And so in the morning, I have children from all over, ukuleles, whatever they can do. So here's the actual performance. We have students in the background playing the ching. We had the score tom and the sampo. Drums and the students were playing. And I don't have a recording of it, but it was lovely. And I do have recordings, just people don't know how to share them on Google Drive yet. So we do have it recorded. We also have, that's the performance. These kids, Maddox is not only, as we met many people in Cambodia who just seem to be creative in many ways, that he's also an artist. He makes sculptures, he does all kinds of things, so I'm sure some of you will be seeing him later. So he drew this, he was so excited that he drew a little poster and brought it in the day of the performance. Here's our principal, Jason DiCarlo, introducing the students and telling Maddox's story. And there's Maddox taking all the accolades for helping to teach the other students. And here is a video of the coconut deeds, or part of it. Okay. This is on April 23rd on International Day. The costumes came from a colleague of mine. She said, well, I don't have the wrap kind of take too long, but here, try these. So we just fit them up. Also, again, you should have an odd number. I had 12 students. I wasn't going to tell two of them they couldn't dance because we needed, you know, 5 sets. So we have an extra set of students in the group. That's okay. All are welcome.
Thank you.
very happy that they were able to do it. And again, some kids would, you know, just move in their coconuts. Other kids have a lot of coordination with the stylistics. So next year we can maybe take a time where just the boys work together and they work on those little, the head should be tilting. So there's so much more we can do. But I think it was a great beginning and they were thrilled. And our assistant principal is just wonderful at celebrating children. So here they are and there they are. They were very happy with their performance. Going on to next steps for my curriculum and community outreach, we can develop and refine the coconut dance. We can seek volunteers in the community. A lot of them said, my mother would, so, you know, knows this dance or danced it. So we could have someone come in if we had maybe several class periods. Those children are all in different classrooms, so that's the difficult part. So my goal is perhaps simplify coconut dance where they can all learn one part of it and then improvise some movements for a B section and come back to that. The A section would be a nice project for students in class. Then I could do it with an entire class if we didn't have a performance goal in mind. For Pin Pete, we really need to seek some funding so that we can have Master Song Han come and teach the students who show promise in the exploration, and that's really the goal for that, for traditional Pin Pete music, because we still need to work on keeping that alive. Improvisation and composition in my grade 4 brings me up to the circus. My little aha moment, my epiphany, was when I went to the circus and we heard, it was the Selpak Punlo, I think I have it on the next slide. Yes, okay. Fair Punlo Selpak Art School in Battambang. There are students from elementary through, I think about 1,000 students from elementary through high school and early college age in this school. And they can study music and dance and arts, drawing, painting. I did find a coloring book there that Maddox was so excited to see. So we saw the circus playing over here, and then I'm going to have you listen to the music and see if you can make the connection from the music that we played earlier. So here's what they were doing on the stage. The circus was coming. Over here on the right where the ensemble was. You'll see they've got the kung tum up on stilts so they can stand up and play it. They've got some of the other traditional instruments, but over here there's an electric guitar and back here's the drum set. And I said, oh, we can play it with our modern music. So I was very excited there. And if you listen, this just fits so well into my fourth grade improvisation unit because they're just repeated motifs. You'll hear everything 8 times. They do 8 times and then they move on to a new one 8 times. We don't have advanced musicians, but we have one group who can play their part 8 times, and the other group can play their part 8 times and go back and forth, and that's what we're working on now, and they're having a lot of fun. The instruments are a little bit too delicate for me to allow every student to work on it, so we're using our xylophones, ukuleles, recorders, but when somebody has something really beautiful, I say, can you go find that on that? And then I just invite a few students to play, and that's how we'll incorporate them into our current curriculum. And so you'll hear these motifs just over and over. Purchase a few videos and some CDs, so we have great examples to show the students and what child is intrigued by circus. So it's a great motivator, and it makes them really feel when they have a goal, oh, we're doing something that's real life applications. They really take it more seriously. So I'm excited to be doing, we're starting this year, but I have new ideas for next year. And finally, we have the documentary project that we talked about. Ian Koss is right now pursuing a doctorate in ethnomusicology in Boston, and he and Heidi Shin are co-producers of a documentary for NPR where they're exploring how music experiences can connect students from immigrant families who've been displaced through war or other conflict to their parents and grandparents, to their cultural history, to their community. And so Heidi was there on the International Day. She may have a recording of the Pin Pete. She saw their performances, but she also was able to talk to the students, and she's going to come back in a few weeks, and she has certain students, like Maddox, that she wants to connect with a little more deeply, and some students at the Stoplosa that we talked about, I'll have to connect there. So that's exciting too, because it helps the students to see that other people are interested in the work we're doing. And that when she asked the students, why is this important, they really had some great answers. Well, it's important because people don't know about this, because our parents maybe don't talk about this. And so it's important to know our history and know who we are. And one boy finally said, it gives us pride. It gives us pride in ourselves and our culture. And so those are the, you know, that's the goal, to know who you are and to know that other people are interested to preserve it and share it. So that's where we're going. Okay. Thank you.